Moments before addressing the United Nations General Assembly on Tuesday, U.S. President Donald Trump appeared to confirm reports he temporarily halted millions of dollars in aid to Kiev ahead of a controversial phone call with the Ukrainian leader.
As far as withholding funds, those funds were paid. They were fully paid. But my complaint has always been, and I withhold again, and I'll continue to withhold until such time as Europe and other nations contribute.
The president is facing new questions a day after the Washington Post reported Trump ordered the administration to block almost $400 million in military aid to Ukraine, at least a week before he spoke with President Volodymyr Zelenskiy. On that call, the president is alleged to have pressed Zelenskiy to investigate Democratic presidential primary candidate Joe Biden and Biden's son. Trump said he said nothing wrong in that call and on Monday denied pushing for any quid pro quo.
I did not make a statement that you have to do this or I'm not going to give you aid. I wouldn't do that.
But Democrats are warning that if the president tried to coerce a foreign nation into investigating and prosecuting a domestic political rival, that could constitute soliciting election interference. And the White House is facing a chorus of demands to release transcripts of Trump's call with Zelenskiy. Former Secretary of State John Kerry made the case to CBS on Sunday.
The only way to get at it is release the transcript. Let everybody see what the president said. And if he leveraged American foreign policy and foreign aid to get a president of another country to be the opposition research arm of his campaign, that is a fundamental, profound, and deeply disturbing abuse of power.
The conversation with Zelenskiy is reported to be the subject of a whistleblower complaint made to the Intelligence Community Inspector General. Democratic lawmakers have demanded the administration hand over the complaint, but the acting director of national intelligence appointed by Trump has so far blocked that request. Senate Democratic Minority Leader Chuck Schumer on Tuesday insisted the complaint be made available to Congress.
This morning, I am focused on getting the Inspector General of the Intelligence Community to provide Congress with the whistleblower complaint as required by law.
It's nonsense.
Trump has at times suggested the White House might release a transcript of the call, but the administration has so far refused to do so. Donald Trump has claimed without evidence that as vice president, Joe Biden tried to pressure Ukraine in order to benefit a business linked to Biden's son. The acting director of national intelligence is set to testify about the whistleblower affair before the House Intelligence Committee on Thursday.